This is a day of mixed emotions, ladies and gentlemen, for all of us in this room. We are angered by the senseless and brutal murder of this young woman, and we want justice served. Yet we're also very proud today by the fact that we can finally offer some closure and some peace. Let me paint a picture for you of this heinous crime committed over 20 years ago. On July 21st, 1999, an individual walking along 92nd Street, that is between 6 and 7 Mile Road in the town of Raymond, discovered a young woman's body lying discarded in a cornfield several feet from the roadway. She suffered from significant injuries and had been brutalized by many means over a long period of time. All of us here who have investigated the deaths of individuals over the course of our careers have seen many troubling things. However, the utter barbaric brutality inflicted on this young woman is something that none of us will ever forget. Our investigative team has spent thousands of hours over the past 20 years in an attempt to identify our victim and bring her killer to justice. We've examined well over 1,000 missing person cases around this country and have traveled to several states following up on investigative leads. Her DNA was entered into a nationwide unidentified victims database. As new technologies were developed, her DNA was submitted for genealogical testing, and her body was exhumed for chemical isotope testing, which was conducted by the Smithsonian. Year after year after year, we plugged away at this case, never giving up. A number of weeks ago, and more than 20 years since her body was found, our investigative team developed information that led to her identification. She is Peggy Lynn Johnson. She was born on March 4th, 1976. She was 23 years old when she was murdered. 23. She was born and raised in McHenry, Illinois. Her mother, her father, and her brother are all deceased. She has a sister whom she has never met. After her mother died, Peggy, who was approximately 18 years old, cognitively impaired, on her own, went searching for help at a medical clinic in McHenry, Illinois. There, she met a registered nurse named Linda LaRoche, who recognized Peggy's disability and took her into her home. Peggy lived with LaRoche in McHenry for the last 5 years of her life. There, she suffered long-term and horrific abuse at the hand of Linda LaRoche. As I said earlier, over the last 20 years, we have dedicated thousands of investigative hours to bring this heartbreaking murder to its resolution. That day has arrived today. On Tuesday, this past week, November 5th, in Cape Coral, Florida, Linda LaRoche was taken into custody by members of the Racine County Sheriff's Office investigative team. She was brought into custody for the brutal murder of Peggy Lynn Johnson. She has waived extradition, and she will soon be back in Racine, Wisconsin to be held accountable for what she has done. I would also like to add that until recent weeks, neither Linda LaRoche or Peggy Johnson's names have ever come up in our investigation. Also, Peggy was never listed as a missing person. I think that is important to understand. Peggy is currently buried as Jane Doe, as we know, at the Holy Family Cemetery in Caledonia, Wisconsin. In the coming weeks, we are going to make arrangements for Peggy Lynn Johnson to be buried alongside her mother in Belvedere, Illinois, where she can be laid to rest with her true identity and at some level of peace. Oftentimes, these cases, as we know, grow cold in terms of investigative leads, but they must never grow dust or be forgotten. Lastly, and of course, never given up. This was a philosophy from our former sheriffs that we have in this room today, and that remains our philosophy here at the Racine Sheriff's Office today, never giving up. I also want to recognize the hard work and commitment of all the investigators, past and present, who have touched this case, some of which have retired, some in this very room today, others who at this very moment are traveling across this country and putting together the final pieces of this brutal murder together. So on behalf of Peggy Lynn Johnson, her remaining family members, and our entire community, I say thank you. As you can imagine, this investigation is still very, very active and ongoing. That said, if anyone has information about this case, I am asking you to contact Lieutenant Brian Bensock at 262-886-8497. Also, to protect the integrity of this ongoing investigation into this brutal murder of Peggy Lynn Johnson, at this time, I will not be entertaining any questions or speaking further about it. I will, however, commit to this community that I'll share additional details as they become available. Lastly, my team has prepared USB drives that will be provided to the news media that is present here today. And on that USB drive, you'll find a copy of the very briefing I'm reading from today, the summons and complaint from our district attorney's office, and some of the relevant photographs that you also see behind me today as well. Lieutenant Sean Barker and Lieutenant Kerry Madrigal will hand those USB drives out to you as well. I also want to again say thank you for your time and attention today, and may God bless Peggy Lynn Johnson and her family. Thank you.